Hello everyone, my name is Jessica Jong and I'm a Technical Solutions Engineer on the Google Home team. And together with Yigit Uyan, we'll tell you how to make use of analytics and tools to ensure high quality Google Home integration. The goal of this session is to get you familiar with the developer tools for Google Home and to walk you through Google Home analytics in order to improve the quality of your Google Home integration, monitor outages, and set up alerts. This is a typical developer journey that you will go through while developing your integration with Google Home. You can use our rich suite of development tools to learn, develop, and debug, and use analytics to look for errors and monitor outages even after launch. Let's start with the developer tools. Before you start building your own integration, you can, without writing any code, simulate a Google Home integration using the Google Home Playground. This will help you understand how a smart home device works in the Google Home ecosystem. The Google Home Playground is a web application where you can create virtual devices with the traits that you like. Let me show you how easy it is to create a virtual light. First, you need to link Google Home Playground to your account using the Google Home app on your phone. Now, launch the Playground in your browser and sign in. Click on the Add a Device button. Here, you can choose to add a custom device or a predefined set of devices. Let's create our own light here by selecting light type and name it Super Light. Note that the on-off trait is automatically added to the device since it's a required trait for light. We can add other traits after creating the device. Now, click the Create and Add Device button, and the device is created. On the Basic Information tab, you can see the name, ID, and type of the device that we just created. Let's switch to the Traits tab to add a brightness trait to the light. Click on the Edit Traits button to add new traits. From the list of available traits, select Brightness and click Save. Now our light supports the trait of adjusting its brightness. Let's switch to the States tab to view the state of each trait. You can manually adjust the brightness of the device here or use Google Assistant to interact with the device. Once you have gained some familiarity with the Google Home ecosystem, you can begin your own integration using the Google Home extension for Visual Studio Code. The Google Home extension lets you troubleshoot your Google Home integration as you are developing it in your favorite IDE. The Google Home extension provides all the tools that you need for debugging in one place, like Google Assistant Simulator, Cloud Login, Home Graph Viewer, Test Suite, and other tools to simplify your development process. Let's take a look at this fantastic tool. You can install the extension from our developer site or directly from the Visual Studio Marketplace. After signing in, select the project that you're working on. Let's assume that you have completed a light integration. From the Quick Access panel, click on Cloud Login to view the logs from the last 7 days. You can filter by severity or by time range. You may also toggle the real-time button to view the logs in real-time. You can use the Google Assistant Simulator to send an utterance to Google Assistant. And use Home Graph Viewer to check if the device state has changed accordingly. You can also send batch utterances by running an utterance script. Click on the Play button, and you can see how it is sending the scripted utterances one by one. The utterance script can be edited and exported again for later use. You might have noticed the Cloud Login has been showing real-time logs. Switch back to the Home Graph Viewer to view the updated states. Now let's run some tests for the device. Select the device that you want to test and click on the Run Test button.
You will be redirected to the test suite where you can run tests for the device as many times as you want. Whenever you're done, click on the Done button to return to VS Code.
We'll be adding more features to the extension, so don't miss out on the updates. When you're ready to test your Google Home integration, you can use the Google Home Test Suite to run end-to-end tests. You might already be familiar with this tool, as it is required to certify your Google Home integration. We have been adding other features to the test suite, like the Google Account Linking Validation Test for cloud integrations. The validation test checks your OAuth service for potential issues that may fail the account linking or token refreshing process. We have also added tests to check if there's any discrepancy in the device state returned by the query intent and report state. This is how the test suite works. It automatically generates test cases based on the devices and traits in your home graph. The test suite will then simulate user engagement with your Google Home integration. The test suite will send utterances to Google Assistant. This will result in an execute intent being fired to your cloud service or a Google Home device, which will interact with the smart home device and change its state. Finally, your cloud service or Google Home device should tell Google about the new state by sending a report state. If the device state changes as expected, that is, if the resulting device state matches with what the test suite expects to see, the test is considered as passed. Finally, when you complete the test, you are ready to get certified and launch your Google Home integration. And now I'll hand it over to Yigit to talk about how to leverage analytics to detect errors during development and monitor outages after launch.
Thanks, Jessica, for giving us an overview of the tools. My name is Yigit, also a technical solutions engineer for Google Home. Today, I'll be talking about analytics. Since last year, we have expanded Google Home analytics into many areas. We now have individual dashboards for each integration type, including Matter, wrote a new troubleshooting guide for smart home debugging, created a confidence metric tracking your execution success, and released a set of resources on detecting outages. We are going to cover each of these throughout the talk, but first, let's remember how our analytics systems work. Each time when one of your users issues a voice intent, Google will send a request to your fulfillment endpoint. You take this request, execute on your devices, and give us back the result. The pipeline runs very similarly for local and Matter as well, which the main difference is the execution happens locally. So when you respond, if your result indicates an error, doesn't reach back to us, or if we cannot parse it, we count that as an error. For this, we'll increment the metrics and record an error log on your project. As the developer who wants to debug these issues, the debugging flow would include two steps. First, monitor these errors, specifically the breakdown for error codes on your project. And second, search these error codes in your logs to find more information about them. Speaking of error codes, we create a list of error codes that you can return to us in the fulfillment errors and exceptions page. These include things like device stuck, door open, bin full, low battery, and used to control the voice response Google Assistant gives back to the end users. Then we have a set of error codes that we provide for cases such as the fulfillment response we send times out or returns back with no response. We call these platform error codes, which you can find the full list in our troubleshooting page. So knowing these, let's cover a common scenario. You are a prominent manufacturer of a smart light bulb, and you worked so hard to come up with a unique design that works great at the same time. People recognize your success, and your sale numbers are increasing. You made integrations with different ecosystems like Google Home, and leveraging them, you start to expand into different regions around the world. Congratulations, by the way, you are on track to become a global brand. So at the same time, you invested lots of resources to build an architecture that supports your global expansion. Now users around the world can use your devices with very low latencies. Your integrations are doing just great. Then all of a sudden, one day you wake up with a phone call, learning that the majority of your devices do not work anymore. Your team is telling you the incident started 7 hours ago, affecting 85% of your devices, and they are yet to figure out the root cause. So I'll ask you, what do you do at this point? And maybe more importantly, what can you do to prevent something like this? Okay, in this section, we are going to cover the steps to create a pipeline to deal with the unexpected performance drops on your project. And the first thing we are going to cover is monitoring the quality of your project. With Google, the simplest way to do this is through our dashboards. You can access them in Google Cloud Console. After selecting your project, go to Operations, Monitoring, then Dashboards. The dashboards we provide include the Google Home Analytics in the name. The first one you see is the main dashboard, which gives you an aggregate view into your project performance across all your integrations. You can find data for the number of requests your project is handling, how the success rates of your integrations compare to each other, as well as the daily, weekly, and monthly active user numbers here. The next set of three are the integration dashboards, which gives you a detailed view into how each of your integrations are doing. They contain data for reliability, usage patterns broken by device types and traits, a list of top error codes, as well as any metrics unique to that integration type. You'll only have data in these dashboards for the integration types you implemented, whether it's cloud, local, or matter. And we just covered using our metrics and dashboards for monitoring quality. Now it's time to take a look at identifying outages. We have created a new call lab for monitoring outages for smart home. It's accessible through developers.home.google.com/call labs. And I'll try to give some highlights of what's mentioned over there. First of all, it's valuable to watch out for three key outage indicators on your project. During an outage, you'll see a sharp drop in your success percentage chart. Usually when that happens, it will be accompanied by an increase in your request latency, as well as a change in the error breakdown chart. When this happens, the first best move generally is to take a look at your error breakdowns to see which errors might be contributing to your outage. Another outage indicator we created this year is the execution success confidence metric. By comparing the current execution performance with your historic averages, this metric assigns you a score between 0 and 1 every 15 minutes. 1 means your project is performing at or above the historic trends, and 0 indicates that we have detected a sharp drop in your execution success, likely indicating an outage. This metric is based on standard deviations, so if your project has been historically very, very stable, a sharp 20% drop in your execution success might be enough to get this number down to 0. When identifying outages, we recommend to watch out for cases where this metric drops below 0.5 very closely. Now that we know how to identify the outages, it is time to set up the alerts. Automated alerting is a feature of Google Cloud that allows you to watch out for certain changes on your metrics automatically. The policies for alerts are set through the alerting view, which you can access through the Google Cloud Console menu, selecting Operations, Monitoring, then Alerts. Once there, click on the button that says Create Policy. Creating an alerting policy window will walk you through three steps. First, you need to indicate what you are going to track by adding a condition. This should bring up a view that you can select a metric and configure conditions. For selecting a metric, you can type smart home and see the list of metrics that we provide on your project. To monitor outages, select the execution success confidence from the list. Then as a condition, you can configure it in a way that it triggers if the time series is below 0.5 for the most recent data point. Then the second step is to configure a few settings that essentially control who will be notified and how. Notification channels is the list of channels to receive the alerts. We'll use the email as the channel option and enter our email here. You can also receive alerts via SMS, PubSub, or through third-party integrations if you choose to configure so. There are also fields to specify the incident closure behavior. Notify on incident closure sends a separate email when the incident is closed, and incident auto-close duration specifies a period to automatically close the incidents if no action is taken. And the final step is to give your alert a name and write a short documentation. The documentation will be sent to people with your alerts, so make sure to include the steps to troubleshoot. For example, you can include the link to our troubleshooting guide. Once you save your alert, it's going to be listed in the policies section of the alerting view. There is also an incident section to see the past events triggering your alert. From this point on, hopefully you don't get any alerts, but if you do, you'll receive a notification in email indicating when the incident happened and what's the observed value. In the example, we set our threshold to 0.5 and the observed value came out as 0.35, which is below our threshold. So when you get this alert, it is time to go back to the debugging flow and take a look at your error metrics and search them in your logs. In this talk, we covered the developer tools and analytics for our smart home ecosystem. You learned how you can use them to have a high quality and reliable Google Home integration. My name is Yigit, my colleague was Jessica, and we hope what you have seen here today helps you with your Google Home integration. Thanks for joining us.